Hi doctors, my friend has been treated of lung cancer. How is rehabilitation done after this?
Every cancer patient requires support and rehabilitation. So it is always about preparing for the treatment, going through the treatment, and what happens after treatment. Preparation for any treatment requires that the patient goes through a certain exercises, like, you know, good lung exercise to build up the lung volume, what we call as spirometry. So the person prepares the lung for whatever has to be done. Secondly, the person has to prepare with nutrition. That is, you know, we advise usually high protein diet in order to build up the body to go through the treatment. Thirdly, we prepare the body for, or the person's patient's body for this treatment by asking them to exercise. They should exercise at least for about half an hour a day or 1 hour a day by walking, so that the body sufficiently is endowed enough to go through what treatment has been advised. In addition to this, what becomes important for the person is to quit smoking and alcohol so that their body is well ready for whatever surgery is being offered or treatment is being offered. Treatment could be surgery, it could be chemotherapy, it could be radiotherapy, or it could be some form of a target therapy. Whichever form of treatment it is, a person needs to prepare. Once the treatment is completed, all this preparation which has been done comes into use, because body recovers faster. It continues to support the treatment which is going on or which has already been completed. So rehabilitation process truly begins before the treatment starts and continues through the treatment and afterwards. And that is when the treatment becomes successful. Also, very important part of any cancer treatment, including lung cancer, is the support group. The knowledge that is being shared with them, the right kind of knowledge, the right kind of information is very important. Secondly, the right kind of group or the people who are supportive, who give them the support to go through the treatment, also have to be there. We also, you know, through our NGO Samrohana, under which all these videos are being made, is a support group where we have platform for other patients or for other patients to communicate with each other, to know more about the cancer treatments which are available across the world and share their opinions and difficulties and ease them out. Because when you share your difficulties, they reduce, they come down. So you need to share them, you need to share with each other, and you will find solutions from each other.
Rehabilitation for lung cancer starts from the time of diagnosis, and it also continues after finishing your treatment also. It mainly has three aspects. One is your physical fitness, emotional fitness, and nutritional balance also. Most of the patients might have received chemotherapy before undergoing surgery also, and chemotherapy also affects your lung. Even radiation also affects your lungs. So for us, how we take it is, if the patient is more fit before going for surgery, then the outcomes of the surgery will be good, the recovery will be faster. So most of the times we try to prepare the patient physically before the surgery. So before starting surgery itself, from the time of diagnosis, we prepare the patient's lungs in the form of some exercises, some breathing exercises, spirometry, brisk walking, climbing stairs, and you can do some yoga or pranayama, deep breathing exercises. All the importance of these exercises is to improve your lung function. So even after removing a part of your lung, you will be able to lead a healthy life. Immediately after surgery, you might have little difficulty in breathing because of the surgical marks, and your diaphragm might be little weaker. So all these exercises which we train you before surgery helps you in a faster recovery. That's the importance of preoperative preparation. Along with that, post-surgery also, you are supposed to follow all these exercises so that you can lead a healthy life. Not only this, rehabilitation also includes emotional balance as well. So you need to be psychologically strong, and if required, meet a counselor and prepared for the duration of treatment. Lung cancer treatment includes surgery, chemotherapy and radiation. So you should be emotionally fit to accept all these treatments and carry further. Not only patient, even patient family members also needs to be counseled about the treatment. And cancer is a highly metabolic state, so patient would have lost a lot of his nutrition. And during chemotherapy, not only cancer, even cancer treatment makes you more weak. So you should be nutritionally fit as well. So before surgery itself, sometimes lung cancer patient might also have difficulty in swallowing. So we will be rehabilitating you with the nutrition therapy as well. So we will be counseling the patient about the importance of nutrition and dietary habits which you have to follow before the surgery, during the surgery and after the surgery. So by rehabilitating the patient physically, emotionally and keeping a good nutritional balance helps patient recover faster and finish his treatment properly. Cancer is a highly catabolic state. Patient will not have any appetite, they would have lost weight. Not only the disease, even after receiving various kind of treatments, for example, surgery itself is a traumatic procedure. After taking chemotherapy, you might not have appetite and you are going to lose most of your weight. So how are you going to rehabilitate this part? So for this, you need to have a protein-rich diet. Most of the patients will be given a diet counseling on what kind of food they have to consume before surgery, during surgery or post surgery, along with other adjuvant modalities like chemotherapy and during radiation therapy also. Addition of protein-rich diet with required vitamins and other minerals will help in faster recovery of the patient. It also helps in taking the treatment properly, and you can have good results post any kind of treatment. Thank you.
If you want to know more about cancer, subscribe to our channel. We come up with many videos and information as we go on.